Toru Takemitsu was a Japanese composer who became renowned for his avant-garde compositions, blending traditional Japanese music with Western classical and avant-garde techniques. Born in Tokyo in 1930, Takemitsu started his musical education at an early age and went on to become one of the most significant composers of the 20th century. Takemitsu's association with mid to late century Japanese artists was pivotal to his artistic development, especially when it came to his collaborations with film directors such as Masaki Kobayashi and Akira Kurosawa. As a child, Takemitsu experienced World War II firsthand, which left a lasting impact on his life and music. While serving in the military, Takemitsu first encountered Western classical music through a French song called Parlez-moi d'amour, a French chanson written by Jean Lenoir and recorded by Lucien Boyer in 1930, the same year that Takemitsu was born. This is the song you hear playing. It was played on a gramophone with a makeshift bamboo needle, and Takemitsu listened to it in secret with his colleagues. This experience sparked his curiosity about Western music, which would ultimately influence his unique style of composition. Despite the challenges, Takemitsu's early musical education began at a young age. He was largely self-taught and started to develop his style in the post-war era. Takemitsu was heavily influenced by Western classical music, particularly with the works of composers such as Debussy, Stravinsky, and Messiaen. He was also interested in the American avant-garde, particularly the works of John Cage. Takemitsu's early compositions were received with mixed reviews. While some praised his innovative approach to music, others criticized his departure from traditional Japanese music. Despite the initial reception, Takemitsu continued to hone his craft and push the boundaries of music. Toru Takemitsu's early compositions marked a significant departure from traditional Japanese music. He was part of a larger movement of Japanese artists who sought to explore new forms of artistic expression, and his music reflected the profound changes taking place in post-war Japan. In the wake of World War II, Japan was undergoing a period of rapid change, and a new generation of artists emerged who were interested in exploring new creative possibilities. In 1951, Takemitsu was a founding member of the Jikin Kobo, an interdisciplinary artistic group that focused on collaborative experimentation with mixed media projects. During this period, Takemitsu composed a number of works, some of which involved the use of electronic tape recording. One such piece was Relief Statique, his 1955 piece, which you can currently hear. Takemitsu found himself at the forefront of the Japanese avant-garde movement, which sought to push the boundaries of music and art in new directions. Inspired by the music of Western composers such as John Cage and Olivier Messiaen, Takemitsu began to incorporate avant-garde techniques and non-traditional instruments into his compositions. Some of his most important works from this period include his well-known Requiem for Strings and November Steps. In Requiem for Strings, Takemitsu experimented with the timbre and texture of the strings to create a mournful and introspective sound. He also used silence as a compositional element, creating long stretches of quiet that emphasized the emotional impact of the music. In November Steps, a piece commissioned by the New York Philharmonic, Takemitsu combined traditional Japanese instruments, such as the biwa and shakuhachi, with the Western orchestra. The result was a unique and haunting sound that captures the beauty and melancholy of the changing seasons. Takemitsu was no stranger to this instrumental orientation, as it is one that he employed in several film scoring ventures throughout his career. Takemitsu was an artist who was strongly influenced by Western classical music, particularly the works of composers such as Debussy, Stravinsky, and Messiaen. However, as he matured as an artist, he became increasingly interested in exploring his own cultural heritage the more he worked with other Japanese artists and proceeded with incorporating traditional Japanese instruments and musical styles into his compositions. Takemitsu also credited John Cage, an American composer and music theorist, for his interest in returning to traditional Japanese music. Cage had a strong interest in Zen Buddhism and encouraged Takemitsu to explore his own cultural heritage. This led Takemitsu to incorporate traditional Japanese instruments and musical styles into his compositions, creating a unique synthesis of Eastern and Western musical traditions. This synthesis became a hallmark of Takemitsu's musical style and contributed to his innovative and eclectic approach to composition. Takemitsu's interest in returning to traditional Japanese music was sparked in part by his experience of what is known as cage shock. Cage and Takemitsu were friends after they met in Japan in the year 1958, and like many of his Japanese contemporaries, Takemitsu was deeply influenced by John Cage's philosophy and compositional techniques, especially those that emphasized the use of chance and indeterminacy in music. Takemitsu began to explore chance music in his own compositions, including pieces such as Corona. Corona is a composition for solo piano written by Toru Takemitsu in 1962 that consists of 5 etudes or circles, with various techniques suggested for the performer to choose from. Some of these techniques include striking the piano strings with the fingers or hand to create a percussive effect, plucking the strings with the fingers to produce a harp-like sound, using the sostenuto pedal to sustain notes, and create a ringing, resonant effect strumming or brushing the strings with a guitar pick or another object, playing the strings directly behind the hammers with the fingers, and using the una corda pedal to soften the sound of the piano. The piece is highly interpretive due to its unusual nature, and each corona can be started at any point on the perimeter. The first corona contains a specific rhythmic and melodic motif, while the others are more open in terms of pitch and harmony. While Toru Takemitsu was known for his avant-garde compositions, he was also a prolific film composer. In this section, we'll take a closer look at his approach to film scoring and some of his most notable collaborations. Takemitsu's collaboration with director Masaki Kobayashi on the 1964 film Kwaidan is a perfect example of his approach. In the film, Takemitsu's score incorporates traditional Japanese instruments such as the biwa and shakuhachi. He also incorporates recorded sounds to create a sonic landscape that is both familiar and otherworldly, further immersing the audience in the film's supernatural atmosphere throughout the film. This includes the concrete music that Takemitsu incorporates, which refers to the use of recorded sounds, often manipulated and transformed through various techniques such as filtering, looping, and pitch shifting. One of the best examples of Takemitsu's use of recorded sounds, adding an extra layer of depth and meaning to the traditional music, would be during the final performance of the Battle Dan no Ura to the Spirits, where the sound of waves crashing is used in the background, creating an eerie and haunting effect that enhances the overall emotional impact of the scene and further contextualizes the setting of the battle in the sense of its traditional story from the tale of the Heike. Takemitsu's score for Akira Kurosawa's Ran is another notable work from his film scoring career. Takemitsu incorporated traditional Japanese instruments with Western orchestration, creating a unique and powerful sound that underscored the epic and tragic scope of the story. The score for Ran is often regarded as one of Takemitsu's greatest achievements as a film composer. Takemitsu collaborated with other filmmakers throughout his career, including Masahiro Shinoda on Silence, and again, Masaki Kobayashi on Harakiri. In his score for Harakiri, Takemitsu's utilized traditional Japanese instruments to establish a musical presence. Unlike the traditional rhythmic grid, Takemitsu composed in blocks of time, a distinctive approach he adopted early on when in use with the traditional instruments of Japan. In this scene, you can appreciate his use of silence while the tension builds in the scene, followed by a climactic crash of the biwa, again followed by silence and continued tension. An auditory impact meant to stun the audience.
Akazonai no buyū nado to wa iinagara, iike no gokafū mo shōsen, bushi no menboku no uwabe dake o kazaru mono.
Through his pioneering work in blending traditional Japanese music with avant-garde and Western classical techniques, Toru Takemitsu's legacy continues to inspire and influence contemporary musicians and composers, both in Japan and around the world. His innovative approach to composition has paved the way for new generations of artists to explore the possibilities of fusing different musical traditions and pushing the boundaries of what is possible in music. Takemitsu's impact on the world of music will continue to be felt for years to come, as musicians continue to draw on his pioneering spirit and innovative vision.